Hi, my name is Patryk Zawadzki, and I am the CTO and co-founder of Saleor Commerce. Saleor's GraphQL API empowers developers to solve difficult problems more easily. We've got strong support for Omnichannel, we offer an open source and cloud option, and Saleor is in production at global scale. It's also the world's most popular open source commerce platform. Today, I'll explain why headless commerce emerged, why modern complexities require a headless approach to commerce, and how commerce APIs, like Saleor, can leverage Next.js for better performance. I started commerce development in 2009, and at that time, the platform seemed to have commerce solved. The monolithic approach, with one massive backend rendering a single frontend, brought lots of efficiency. Platforms competed at being feature-rich, one-stop shopping for all things commerce software. But the architecture required innovation to happen in-platform. And as platforms fell in and out of favor, teams had to either wait for new innovation to come from the vendor or face the time-consuming and expensive replatform to the shiniest new solution. It was never ideal, but the giant monolith worked quite well until commerce needed to be available everywhere. The future of commerce is decentralized. A headless architecture is the only path to decentralization, which is why brands pushing the UX envelope, like the Lush team, are making commerce choices based on openness and performance rather than on a checklist of cookie-cutter features. Over the years, we moved from architecture that looked like this to building sites that looked like this. At first glance, having everything built into a single monolith is attractive, but the accelerating pace of innovation makes it obvious no single platform can keep pace indefinitely. In 2021, feature completeness is a moving target pursued by hundreds of independent teams. So today's best platform is the best team player. You see, headless is not groundbreaking tech in and of itself. The excitement is around what it enables. And what headless enables is rapid adaptation. Rather than replacing a slab of code every 3 years, tech teams can meet business needs on a continuous basis. There's no waiting on a platform, the team's now able to solve its own problems. Decoupling the frontend from the backend, with multiple backends separated by concern, gives you the ability to scale, which finally takes commerce everywhere. And headless benefits increase with complexity. Several factors make commerce complex. There's a need to go to new markets quickly, the different currencies, languages, and shipping providers, but also regional requirements on everything from business ops to marketing tools to social media platforms, and even opinions on what makes great UI vary by region. So keeping commerce fresh means constantly changing requirements. And the complexity of modern commerce means platforms must become more sophisticated. At Saleor, platform sophistication means leveraging innovation from the centralized teams, adapting rapidly to changing commerce requirements, and easing the path to global scale. But global scale means performance is held to the most exacting standards. There is a direct connection between page speed and sales revenue, plus performance optimization means more efficient use of resources, which becomes critical during major events like a Black Friday sale. And performance is exactly what Next.js brings to the table. Let's start with images, crucial to how products are perceived. In commerce, when you look at Lighthouse results, unoptimized images often stick out as a sore thumb. Because sending a 30 megabyte image to the mobile user is not what you want to do, you must only send what's absolutely necessary, but what's absolutely necessary depends on the user. It changes with each session, as we must load high-resolution images for higher-density screens. We must serve next-generation formats like WebP or AVIF to take advantage of better compression. And we must be ready to support future advances in imaging, like taking advantage of increased fidelity of HDR screens, for example. Ideally, you don't want your staff doing this manually. They'll either hate doing that or not do it at all. Next.js offers a way to automate all of this with the image component and the image optimization pipeline that you can customize. So Next.js will take the source image and generate all of the required formats. And it will also generate the HTML code required to select the optimal image based on the user's browser, screen density, screen size, etc. But even with images out of the picture, you're not yet free of performance concerns, because it's important to get accurate information about your user's experience. So it's not enough to make sure your HTML is delivered quickly, because experience may depend on other external resources and factors. So it's impossible to obtain those metrics on your end, and you must measure where the metrics are available, which is in the browser, with things like network latency, fonts, or external scripts. It doesn't matter if your site renders in 20 milliseconds, if the user has to wait another 5 seconds for the fonts to load. Luckily, Next.js Analytics can collect all of these for you. But to measure, you need to first bring traffic to your site, and no one will visit your page if they are unable to find it. So far, Google is the only search engine that supports React natively, which means by rendering everything in the browser, you could be missing out on entire countries or even continents where the dominating search engine is simply not Google. This means we need to do some pre-rendering. And the easiest way to solve this is with static site generation. An SSG does work great with Next.js. Unfortunately, it also has a major limitation. Because every time your data changes, you need to rebuild and redeploy. And data does change often in commerce, because prices change, products sell out, sales start and end, and there's a physical limit to how many pages you can generate. Because if generating a single product page takes 100 milliseconds, then rendering a million of those would take more than a day. So we need to take a step back and consider server-side rendering. And now, SSR does solve the problem of data freshness while keeping the SEO benefits of SSG, but it also sacrifices the benefit of only rendering each page once, which can actually result in the site being slower than if everything was rendered in the browser. So a hybrid solution would be better. We could pre-render some of the pages, like the most popular products, and then render everything else on demand. Next.js allows us to do just that by using the fallback mode. The most popular products become part of a static build, so they always load quickly. But it's not a complete solution yet. We still have the problem of data changing, which requires us to discard all of the previously rendered pages. But Next.js can also help with that. The cache invalidation API allows us to only cache each page for so long, and once the time is up, do a background check to see whether the page needs to be updated. Those two features combined with SSR form a pattern called incremental static regeneration. But at Saleor, we believe we can do even better than that. So, together with Vercel, we are working to make invalidation real-time. So you could have very long cache times for your pages, with it changed to the data being reflected immediately. Stay tuned for future announcements around this area. And Next.js solutions to hard commerce problems like image optimization, UX metrics, SEO, ISR, and soon-to-be real-time ISR are important enough when you're on a single website, but in our omni-channel world, with multiple teams working on multiple storefronts, all those people constantly updating the information necessary to render your pages, using Next.js to move towards real-time is essential. But real-time caching validation is not the only thing on our radar. Today, Next.js announced another feature. Edge functions allow you to process requests even before they reach the server. And for commerce, that means easy A-B testing. It also means an easy way to gradually roll out features based on either time or geographical area. But as my time here is limited, I've only scratched the surface of what Next.js makes possible. So, key takeaways. Modern challenges mean a more sophisticated approach to commerce. First, it must easily incorporate innovation from decentralized teams. Second, it must adapt continuously to business requirements. Third, it must deal effectively with the new omnichannel commerce everywhere reality. And finally, it must deliver breathtaking performance. Saleor handles the decentralized, continuous adaptation, and commerce everywhere requirements with its vast GraphQL API, sound apps architecture, and powerful omnichannel features. But truly breathtaking performance requires Next.js. Together with Next.js, Saleor delivers the most sophisticated solution to modern commerce. And like Vercel, we're building in the open. But as a developer, I know you'll want to test that claim yourself, so we've made it easy. You can go to saleor.io/next.js2021, where you will find everything you need to get started, from a comprehensive Saleor tutorial to a complimentary Saleor Cloud Sandbox environment, and more on non-technical Saleor benefits, like a dashboard your team will love, a cloud option with easy-to-understand pricing, and details on cloud support options. I'm going to leave you with a quick run through our tutorial, which shows how to put the concepts I've discussed in practice with Saleor and Next.js. Even if you lack experience in commerce, you will be able to follow along at your own pace. You'll start in the command line to install the necessary components. Then you'll learn how to use Saleor's powerful GraphQL API. One thing you will notice right away is that Saleor handles a lot of the complexity for you, freeing you to focus on vital UX components like beautiful product pages and lightning-fast search. Finally, you'll implement the Next.js optimization techniques I've discussed previously, like image optimization and ISR, to achieve truly breathtaking performance. Together with Vercel, we're building the future of commerce. Thank you.